Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and tonight we're going to build a shark tunnel, a working shark tunnel right here in Planet Zoo. It's going to have tunnels, it's going to have sharks. They're the two main requirements on how to build a shark tunnel. And this has always been an easy thing to do, relatively. All you basically do is make a pit, fill it with water, and then turn on tunneling for your path and drag your path underneath the ground. And a little bit of it will sort of pop up and you can then make a tunnel over the top. This isn't a tutorial on how to do this. If you want a tutorial for this, Paul's Lay, I think in particular, has a really good one out there. And it's worth checking out if you want to do this in your own games. You can do this completely unmodded. This is our modded series. The animals we're going to bring in are going to be modded. The sharks, for example. But the actual tunnel itself, you can make whenever you want. And you can put, you know, seals in there. You can put penguins in there, stuff like that. There's loads of stuff you could put in. All of the deep diving animals. We did it with crocodiles in our aquatic park, I believe. That's crocodiles. Yeah. So anyways, building a shark tunnel. Nice and simple shape here, just doing a little curve. It is easier and will look neater if you do it in a straight line, because curves means the glass kind of overlaps in little bits, but you know, it's a tunnel, it's curvy, it's cool. I preferred the curviness, so I decided to go for the curviness. And just got about the height right about where I want it there, and we're just going to start laying the path down underneath the water. Or we will in a minute. I'm just trying to neaten things up a teeny tiny bit. Now, I should give humongous credit for this video to Leaf Productions, who has made a ton of fantastic mods out there. Like I say, you can build this without mods, but the animals we're going to put into it are all modded. And not only is that sharks, three species of shark, including a hammerhead shark, but it's turtles, sea turtles, and tons of different species of fish. There are so many aquatic mods all of a sudden, and it's really, really cool and fun stuff to build with. Just putting a little fence on here. I'm not worrying too much about how the outside of this looks. I've had a little thought, which I want to float by you people. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But I'm not worrying too much about the outside. It's all about what it looks like in the tunnel. A little divot there. You need an area for your staff members to come in and drop the fish. They will spend a little bit of time on land. They will spend a little bit of time on the surface. It's just how it is. But you can, you know, just have a tiny little sliver of land where they get sort of dropped in, and as long as you can't view it from above, you know, you can only view it from the tunnel, you'll never ever see that anyway, so it kind of works out. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Now, I've got to say, this entire build you're seeing took about an hour and a half, hour and 20 minutes? Hour and a half, something like that. You can build a pretty nice looking shark tunnel, and a pretty big one at that. I would actually, in retrospect, I should have made it smaller. I wanted to shove every fish in, basically, and just sort of try things out. But I like the idea of doing a much smaller one so you can see them a lot more often. It feels a little bit more claustrophobic, but in a nice way. And here I'm just sort of lowering the height off the ground so that the tunnel, when I put the path in, is a little bit closer. So there's less of a gap between the bottom of the water and the path itself, because that should, you know, look a little bit better. It should look more like an actual tunnel. Whereas in the past, the one we did on the crocodile, it had really high walls. This one kind of ends up with them anyway, but it's sort of along the way. Make sure you turn off your path supports and your curbing and stuff like that. That's what I'm getting rid of here, but you just do that before you put those in as well. It's a little tip. And what you're going to use to actually make the tunnel is that glass thing I've got there. It's one of the classic British things. It's meant to be like an awning or like a shelter sort of thing. I think it's to hang above a window. But if you strew them together in a big old line, you can make this glass tunnel shape because it's curvy and glass. Like a tunnel. So we grab loads of these. Hopefully you'll see the name. Just changing the colour. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. And grab these and boom. I just search for glass and it shows up. I'm trying to spot the name. Bear with me. Let's see if we can grab it at some point. No. It's arch. It's like classic glass arch or something like that. But there you go. Anyway, so you just kind of stick these together. And make sure there's no gaps. You know, you can have gaps if you want, though you can technically, if you wanted to, you could flood the path. It wouldn't matter. Pretend your guests can breathe underwater if you would like to do that. Personally, I like to pretend that it's real, so just make sure there's no gaps as you're moving your tunnel along, basically. But yeah, the entire thing, hour and a half, something like that. You can whip this together really, really quickly. That was one thing I really wanted to do with this series, was showcase what you can do in a short amount of time. And I'm not like a particularly special builder or anything like that compared to some people out there. So if I can do it, you can definitely do it. Planet Zoo definitely has this reputation of being very tedious. You know, it takes a lot of time to get things done. And to an extent, that is definitely true, don't get me wrong. But you can achieve pretty cool looking results. Not tippity-toppity-bippity-boppity, but tippity Hoppity. There you go, that's lower tier apparently, in a pretty good amount of time. Now, whilst I'm shoving these tunnels down, I want to talk to you guys about something, as I've realised that when I'm making this zoo, all the builds I want to do are aquatic-based. I want to do a shark tunnel, I want to do the orcas, we have the penguins, I want to do a thing with the turtles, all these fish feel like they should have their own habitats, and there's even more aquatic creatures that I didn't touch in preparation for this build. So, what we might do, this was never a real park, this is more a mod showcase. Today I'm trying to showcase all the different fantastic fish that Leaf has made, and Leaf really deserves all the love in the world, honestly. Leaf is a god, as far as I'm concerned. What was I saying? I don't know, I'm just praising Leaf. so the side is always going to be a little bit messy, you get this bibbly bobbly stuff. I don't know what's wrong with me, I sound like Dr. Zeus today. And I'm just going to cover it with rock. I think you could do something a little neater. If it's a straight line, this would be easier, but because it curves and stuff like that, it makes it harder to work with. I think if you did a straight line and did this a lot smaller, you could actually have this very, very neat and tidy, and maybe use concrete or plaster or something like that to make it look a little bit more professional. Me, I quite like my haphazard sort of style, and it kind of blends in with the rock outside of the tunnel, so I'm okay with that. But I think if we, the next time we do this, talk about that in a second, we're probably going to try something a little bit different. So whilst I'm shoveling all these rocks down, what I like the idea of doing is building an aquarium, all indoors, basically, like a fully indoor aquarium with buildings, well, with sections and paths and lights and shops and like a full humongous aquarium, and you'd have a shark tunnel. And what I really wanted to do, although I had to save it, at the end of the tunnel. Wait, does this make any sense? Could I realistically do that? Maybe. I was thinking, you know, sometimes in a zoo you have like a central column that's full of water and fish. It's like this massive column and the whole sort of aquarium revolves around that. That's kind of what I wanted. I was wondering if I could link that with the shark tunnel. I think in theory it would be possible, although it wouldn't be easy. Would it be easy? No, it would be very difficult, but it would be possible. I really like the idea. There's a lot of things I want to build, and they all happen to be aquarium-based. And thanks to mods, we have all these fantastic aquatic creatures that we can play with for the very first time. So I am definitely considering starting a new build, putting this on hold for a bit. And like I said, this was never a zoo build. This was always a mod showcase anyway. So I kind of love the idea of starting an aquarium. We do still have our Southeast Asia Zoo, of course. I know it's been a little while. Apologies, by the way, it's been so long since Planet Zoo. I've been distracted with Camp Cretaceous stuff. But for the first time in a while, I'm feeling like a little bit, you know, passionate and kind of like inspired by an idea. And I think using these mods to make a full aquarium would end up looking really, really cool. So I'm tempted about that. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Hit up that comment section and hit the like button when you do. I'm a YouTube person. It's called the tunnel. The aquarium would also have a horror vibe, just saying. Because of course it would. Now, you can't just have the outsides super boring. This is one of the problems with this being so humongous. I would have brought in the walls about, I would have like halved this distance at the side, realistically, and made the tunnel a lot shorter as well. Kind of bring in the sides a lot more around the tunnel itself. A, because it means the animals are more likely to hang around by the tunnel. And B, because it means I don't have to do buttloads of decoration, basically. But you can't leave the sides looking so boring. So hop into a group, grab some faux rocks, and just sort of stick things together to try and make a sort of natural-looking environment, basically. And this is why I need to talk about other stuff. What am I going to talk? This is a short video, and yet I still can't talk about the rocks that much. I'm just putting rocks down. I don't know what to tell you, folks. Just keep up mixing up the shapes. Usually I don't use a line to surface, but I've realized, especially when, like building things like that, sticking on a line to surface allows you to make much more sort of naturalistic looking shapes, because, you know, everything's angled and jutting around. You can kind of mess things around a little bit more, kind of flip between the two depending on what you're trying to achieve, really. But I just wanted the ground to not look so boring. I didn't want this plain dirt area for the animals to live in. They deserve a little bit of love, because I'm going to cram about 120 fish into this habitat. And you've got to remember that each fish is technically like its own animal with needs and wants and food desires and all this kind of jazz. This is not the kind of build you should be attempting on anything other than sandbox, by the by. You could do this not on sandbox with one or two species, but I'm going to use 8 or something. So yeah, I don't recommend it. Filling in some of these gaps now with the underwater eelgrass large. We really need more underwater plants, by the way. These are the only subaquatic plants we have in the entire game. This selection right here, because I've got the subaquatic filter on. And we had an aquatic pack, so I'm a little surprised we didn't get a little bit more. You know, we had an aquatic pack, so why didn't we not get loads of aquatic plants? But a lot of them are still above ground focused. I'm hopeful. I'm still praying that one day we get a Planet Zoo Aquatic update, like a fishy aquarium sort of based update, and maybe then we'll get tons of underwater stuff to play with. Until then, you can still make something decent using rocks, eelgrass, and the other stuff. I think I would want a roof. Would I want a roof? I don't think I'd want a roof. I was trying to remember the last time I went to an aquarium. I went to one here in London not that long ago. And I'm pretty sure when you look up in a shark tunnel, you can usually see the top of the water, right? It's not usually blocked off in any way. Because maybe sometimes you will have a mammal or something in there and you want it to be able to, you know, breathe, for example. And obviously the animals need to be fed and stuff like that. So I think that's fine. I just wish it was a lot smaller, you know? And to compensate for its humongous size, I had to put tons of fish in there. So just like real life. Yeah, it kind of amazed me that you could pull this off so quickly. It's not the neatest thing in the world. I never am, but you can build something pretty awesome in very, very little time. And like I say, if you want to build a tunnel of your own, you can follow what I did in this video, but it's probably quite hard to do so. I really recommend Paul's Lay's tutorial. They're pretty great at that kind of thing, generally speaking. Just chucking in some more plants. Anytime I see an area that looks a little bit dead, a little bit bare, just chucking some more plant life, chucking some more rocks, just, you know, make it look a little bit more interesting, basically. What am I doing? Oh yeah, so I needed the fish feeder. I believe one of the fish, I couldn't remember which one, is based on the caiman. Obviously, they're all based on existing animals, so their enrichment items are all based on those existing animals. And that's the benefit of sandbox. You can kind of ignore that aspect a little bit. The thing is, you don't want enrichment, like, above ground. You know, you don't want land-based enrichment, because then your fish are going to climb onto the ground or climb onto a platform or something, and that looks a little bit weird. So you do need to play on sandbox and kind of neglect your fish a little bit. Now, I wanted to light this tunnel. I had this problem last time as well, and I'm pretty sure I used the same solution here eventually, which is the balls. We'll come back to the balls. Until then, we must light up the feeders themselves. Always handy to stick a few spotlights in there, just so when the animals are feeding, we can see them nice and up close and well lit, especially at nighttime. You know me, I like my exhibits to be nighttime focused. I love my lights. And the aquarium, because it's going to be fully indoors, will be permanently nighttime and completely lit. I envision it in my head, and it looks so good. All these different rooms, and second, you'd have a frosty section, maybe you'd even have a polar bear in there, you'd have your penguins, you'd have a shark tunnel, you'd have like a tropical zone that's got like your crocodiles, caimans, some of your, like, your arrow, yeah, all your different tropical fish. Oh, be so good. My only need is that I can make feeding not necessary. That would help my life. Anyways, the reason I didn't want to use the other lights is because if it's a bright light like the orange ones, it clips on the glass and it makes it harder to see through the glass tunnel, which is obviously kind of against the point considering we're trying to light up the tunnel. I love how that looks, by the way. It looks like space age. It makes it harder to see out the glass, which is what I tried to avoid. So slightly dimmer lights, path not super lit up, but you can see what you're doing, especially from this side, right? Again, it looks like you're entering a freaking spaceship or something. I had fun with this. Just sticking some lights on there, just on the way down. Like I said, I'm not worrying too much about this aspect. I'm just trying to, I don't know, just make it look nice, basically. Make it look acceptable is the goal. Acceptability. Completely unrealistic, but hey, no realism, just vibes. Will always be true. I'm going to put that on a t-shirt, I promise you. Right, anyways, we are actually nearly there. So I've kind of done all the lighting, putting some rock in there so it looks more like it's on purpose. Usually I'd like to cover this up with something, maybe some plaster, maybe some concrete, just kind of block the area off a little bit. But it's got this kind of natural vibe to it, which I don't mind at all. Now we need some bloody fish, however. So sticking down some buildings, again, I'm not really that worried about what this park looks like, unfortunately, so I'm just kind of sticking the buildings in there. I'll probably end up redoing this when we next come back to the park, but I'm leaning very hard towards this aquarium. I do want your opinions and your thoughts and your hopes and your dreams, but I may do it regardless of what you guys say. Anyways, so arowana is what I meant. Arowana. We've got a black tip reef shark. We've got a blue discus, which I'm buying lots of, as you can see. I bought like 25 more of these since. We've got some bluegills. Just the smaller the fish, the more of them I buy, is my philosophy, basically. We've got some giant hammerhead sharks, which I didn't buy many of because they are humongous. Also, that was 50 fish already. I had some slight problems here in that I couldn't seem to get a path to the destination, so I just kind of had to shuffle things around a little bit, re-put the barrier in, and then reattach everything, and it seemed to fix us up. And you can see lots and lots of little fish. It looks really funny because they get put on the ground and they kind of scamper into the water. Eventually, they do spend most of the time underwater, but at this point, it looks utterly bizarre. And the thing is, when you're underwater, you're never really going to see it at the very least. We've got green sea turtles, which is really cool, although one of them's stuck in a box and won't bloody get out. We've got Oscars. We're going to name one Oscar. There's one called Luca. Luca's cool. Lots of Oscars. we've got sandbar sharks. All of these, every single one of these, by the way, made by Leaf. Every single one, I think. Please correct me if I'm wrong. Now, I will say, I should mention very quickly, I know a lot of these fish wouldn't have lived together, okay? I know this is not a natural habitat. My goal literally was, download all the fish that came out this month, put them all in one habitat, so it looks cool. That was as far as the thought went. If we were building an actual aquarium, then they'd all be themed around either biomes or continents or something like that. This was really just to showcase all these really cool animals more than anything else. And I didn't want to spend too much time looking at it in-game, so there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, we will hop in-game. I'm going to show you each species of fish in action. We'll walk through the tunnel at daytime and nighttime. I think it's going to look really cool. I'm very excited to see this. I really haven't had a proper look at this, so let's go check it out. Here we are, folks. So as you can see, there are some problems. The turtles in particular are living their boxy life. But before we take a look at an animal by animal basis, let's tedged cam it up with Yanni. Yanni, we should whip out a piano, as I want to do, and let's go explore our tunnel. So like I say, it could be much better decorated. I really just want to focus on the animals, and it's nice to do a Planet Zoo video where I don't have to play for like 4 hours to be able to bring you guys some content. I'd like to be able to do that a little bit more, you know? Anyways, down we go into the tunnel. I do think it's better at nighttime, but we can check it out. Now, you are about to see a lighting change. I mean, that's pretty cool from here. But then, so the lighting does feel like you're underwater. I think it looks pretty cool still, and there isn't really much we can do about it. It's just part of the experience, you know. This is because technically we are underwater, sort of. But you're a big boy, aren't you? But wait, am I normal speed? Yeah. But it's pretty sweet. I definitely want to come back at night time. Where are all the fish? I can see tons of sharks. Yeah, see, this is just dotted around all over the place. Hop forward a little bit more. Yeah, they do spend a lot of time at the surface. It's why you've got to have these underwater feeders to try to... Hello, buddy. Try to force them down. Make sure there's no gaps here. You will have crossover, as you can see here and here, whenever there's a bend. But then that lets you stop having the gap on this side. Gap on every bloody corner, isn't there, son? Look at that. Look at that hammerhead shark there. I thought that was a shadow, actually. That was cool. But this is cooler. Hammerhead sharks are giant, by the way. They are literally... Look at that shadow! Love the shadows. See how it's cool at night? Daytime. Daytime's cool. But it's not any nighttime, is it? So we're going to nip over here. We're going to head up the stairs, and we're going to swap the time of day. It does look better, actually, I think, before you get in the tunnel. But not much we can do about that. You could actually make the water super transparent. And if the outside was nicer designed and stuff like that, and maybe you were playing at nighttime, then that would actually work out really well. Here we go, look at that. That just looks so good to me. That makes me very happy. That is, like, it's a mess, but just lights and glass and water is a very cool combo. Let's go in to the Starship Enterprise. It's a shame I can see. Wait, can I get rid of that so I can't see that guy over there? There we go. See what we can see. Can we see anything? Anything at all? You do have sharks on your shark tour, right? I really do hate that man. Alright, I'm gonna dash forward a little bit. Apparently they're all hanging out over here. There we go. Any of you wanna... There we go! See, I imagine if this was closer, and they were, like, closer to the window all the time, and there's less room over here, but that is pretty awesome. I think I might need more lights. It's hard to tell. Oh. Yeah. I mean, that is amazing. Such a big shout out to Leaf, honestly. I can't do it enough. They've done some incredible work here. They're a little bit funny in their own way, but considering the game literally doesn't have creatures like this, it blows my mind. It's so good. The hammerheads in particular are super impressive. None of the feeders are doing much of anything, so none of the fish are really hanging out. I mean, they sort of are. You can see tons of them over there. There's that feeder. See, anyone want to come hang out? Look, there's food. Delicious fishies. The sharks look like something out of a horror film, which is very erotic to me. Oh, he's going for a feed. Da 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 da. Just about to see him slinking off into the shadow there. A little fishy there, going by the light. I can maybe place my lights a little bit better as well, it must be said. Alright, love. Oh, hello, buddy. You're cute. That's our black tip. Yeah. Anyways. Yeah, they all seem to like to hang out in the same sort of rough area over here somewhere. I wonder why. And yeah, this is really a problem. You can't really see the little fish. I mean, you can always see the hammerheads because they're gigantic. They catch the light really well. Look at the size of them. But the little fish are kind of... And they add like a nice ambiance to this thing, I would suggest. You know, just being able to see like these little blobs of black shuffling around in the darkness makes it pretty cool. But it would be nice to see them a little bit better. So we can do that. In the tunnel by bringing the walls in closer, but in the actual zoo by having like small tanks dedicated to each fish, basically. I think that is very awesome though. Anyways, folks, that is our shark tunnel. So, disaster from the outside, I'll admit. Hey, who escaped? It's my bloody... Apparently my... How did you... One of my sharks has somehow managed to get it. I have no idea how you possibly do that. That is very impressive, Olivia. You deserve to escape, you really do. Doesn't that look good? That looks so cool! There's too many sharks. I'll admit there's too many sharks. Too many big sharks and not enough fish. I wish I'd made it smaller. I've said that enough times, but I think it's awesome. I actually do prefer it at daytime. It's not words I thought I would say. It's a different vibe, right? That's kind of spooky and stuff, and this is more... It's tropical and it's full of life and... Anyways, let's take a look at some of these animals. So here we have a bluegill. There he is, there's Harrison. Looking fantastic. You know what, I really want piranhas. That's a bluegill. This is our zebra shark. What are you called? Georgia. Oh, Georgia. Hanging out with our other blue discus. No, that's our blue discus, Sophia. She's wibbling, she's wobbling, she's living her best life. That's the hammerhead sharks, of course. This is Tristau, our great hammerhead shark. Absolute unit, to say the least. I'll try to get a better shot of one of these. There we go. The eyes. That is very cool. Actually, tell you what I'll do just for a second. Grab the water, grab this. There you go. Because I need to grab a screenshot off the hammerhead. Okay, who else have we got? Over here we have our sandbar shark, Jacob. Hitting Jake's. Jake's is feeling good. It's quite cool with full transparency. What does it look like inside? Yeah, you can see it doesn't really make a difference at all. Very slight though. Very, very slight. That's pretty sweet actually. Anything else? We should have a few more. The sandbar. That's our arowana down there. No, it's our salmon. Sorry, that's Luca, our sockeye salmon. Who haven't we seen? Ugh, stop it. Sandbar. Sandbar. Everyone's a sandbar. Edwin. Oh, hello. Lots of fish over here. Where is my arowana? There it is. My arowana? I think so. Yeah, an Asian arowana poppy. Living her best life. I have another type of shark, but I can't find the bloody thing. Black-tipped reef shark. There it is. Very cool. And I think that's about it. There might be one more species out there. Oh, yeah, there is. There's Oscar. There's Oscar. Isn't that beautiful looking? What a fantastic design it is. Wait, leave him alone. Oh, zebra shark as well. There's Georgia. Lots of Georgias. What? I mean, that is a beauty of a fish right there. It really is. Yeah, anyways, folks, that's how easy it is. Blah, 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 blah. That's how easy. I'm going to try this one more time in English. That's how easy it is to make a shark tunnel. We can definitely do it a little bit neater. I like the idea of doing it very straight so you can kind of neaten everything up. Imagine it's straight and about half the size and with less sharks. And you could end up with something pretty special, I think. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Are you going to go try and make your own shark tunnel? Like I say, these mods are super easy to install. If you have a copy of Planet Zoo, literally all you do is drag and drop the unzipped files into your OVL data. There are tutorials out there on YouTube telling you exactly how to do it already. Any one of you could build this in under 2 hours, no problem whatsoever. And it would make a pretty cool addition to any aquatic park or anything like that. I'll either take a break from Oakwood now and we'll start this aquarium some point relatively soon because I love the idea, or I will continue with Oakwood for a little bit and I'll neaten this whole area up and kind of blend it all together. We'll have to wait and see. But until then, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye bye. Reaching out.